Hello, 7th standard students. Welcome to the first session of general knowledge. In this video, we are going through the first chapter of your general knowledge test book. Let's see what is explained in the first chapter. The first chapter is about the amendments and schedules of Constitution of India. Just like we have rules in your school diary, Indian Constitution contains rules that need to be followed by each citizen of India. So, Constitution of India, it's a supreme law of India. This document lays down the framework of fundamental political code, structure, procedures, power and duties of government institutions, and set out fundamental rights, directive principles and the duties of citizen. The Constitution of India came into force on 26 January 1950. So that is why we celebrate our Republic Day on 26 January. At the time of its adoption, the Constitution contained 395 articles and 8 schedules. Let's see what is amendment. Amending the Constitution of India, that is the process of making changes to the law that is already written in the Constitution. Let's see some of the amendments, important amendments made to our Constitution. Let's see first the 75th amendment. It is to set up state level rent tribunals. 69th amendment, Delhi made National Capital Territory, NCT. 71st amendment is to include Konkani, Manipuri, Nepali in the 8th schedule of the Constitution. In this 8th schedule, the official languages are mentioned. 22 official languages are there. 53rd amendment is about the conferment of statehood for Mizoram. Then 61st amendment lowered the voting age from 21 years to 18 years. Now let's see the important schedules. The first schedule lists the states and union territories of India. The third schedule explains the forms of oath and affirmation. Fourth schedule, allocation of seats for each state and union territory in the Rajya Sabha is explained. Sixth schedule, administration of tribal areas in Assam, Mizoram, Tripura and Meghalaya. These things are explained there. 10th schedule is about Anti-Defection Act. So children, you have to mark the answers. You need to match these answers of your first chapter. And I'm giving you a supplementary question also. Please prepare the answer for that also. How many states and union territories are there in India? Make a list of it and try to do it yourself. Thank you.